family here? I think we are. We're very, everyone's as cohesive. Everyone helps each other out. Hey y'all, Angela Knight here, Coldwell Banker Realty. Thank you guys for joining us. Today I have my broker, Carrie Collins. She's gonna be telling me a little bit about why choosing Coldwell Banker is a good decision. Our office is located at 566 Spears Creek Church Road, just off of I-20 in Elgin. Very, very conveniently located. We just updated our office and had some fresh paint, some new rooms put in so that everything could be more cohesive and more productive for our agents. So, wanted to ask Carrie just a few questions right quick, and she's got to scoot out of here. Of course, we're busy nowadays. Carrie, thank you for taking the time. I know you're super busy today, and we just wanted to kind of get you in this vlog because I know it's important when agents are getting their license or seasoned agents. Number one, the new agents don't know where to go, and they want to know where they want to go and how it's a good fit. And then seasoned agents may not be happy with where they are and then want to know why Coldwell Banker would be a better choice versus all the other companies out there. So my question to you would be, why choose Coldwell Banker, whether it's a good move for a seasoned agent or for a new agent? So tell us a little bit about Coldwell Banker, the core values that we have, and why Coldwell Banker is a good choice.
Okay, so I'll start with why Coldwell Banker is a good choice, and then I'll talk about why our office is a good choice.
Yes.
So first, Coldwell Banker, we have a long, rich history of producing very successful agents. We are a worldwide company. We have a very large footprint. We also have a lot of brand recognition, and I think that's important in this business. And although agents have their own brand and their own business that follows them, having that national brand that's recognized coast to coast and worldwide is extremely important for credibility and also for getting clients. And we all know that that's what
Absolutely.
Our business is about.
Yes, 100% agree.
And Coldwell Banker is very invested in all of their agents. We do everything, every decision that's made is based upon the core values that we have. Those core values are designed to help agents lead productive and successful lives. Our four core values, of course, as you know, are coaching to confidence.
Yes.
And production power. We coach you to confidence so that you will have production power. Then we just have an awesome culture. So it's actually tagged culture of awesomeness.
Oh.
And yeah, isn't it cute? Yeah.
Culture of awesomeness, guys. Culture of awesomeness.
Yeah.
We are awesome.
Yeah. And we actually live that out every day here in the office. We have a very collaborative office. And our fourth core value, I think, is why most people really enjoy what Coldwell Banker has, because all those four those core values come together and culminate in wealth building. That's really important for us that we help agents not only get today's business, but plan for the future and build, build a solid stream of wealth, both for now and into the future.
And wow.
So as far as our office goes, our company is highly committed to agent success, as I already said, and we have one job here at Coldwell Banker. Our job is to make sure that our agents have a perfect career. And for me, I take that very seriously. That's why I decided to become a broker, is I want to come alongside and just help make sure everybody is living the career they want.
I tell you what, guys, Carrie has been awesome through this pandemic. She has been doing the videos, the team, meeting one-on-one with people, whether it be in the office or online. I'm telling you, this girl does not stop. It's ridiculous. She's always busy, always there to help us. Anytime we have a question, we text her, we call her, and she's right there, which is very important. I have worked for other companies before, and it's nothing like it in the world. It is like working with Coldwell Banker, and especially working with Carrie. This office is amazing. It's very convenient. We're like a family here. I think we are. We're very, everyone's as cohesive. Everyone helps each other out. We have, I think we do have some kind of a mentoring kind of a program to where new agents come on. I actually have a couple that I'm working with that are, they're new. So they want to get started. And so seasoned agents like us would like to help these people grow, which is, again, one of our core values. So I'm going to tell you guys a little bit about Coldwell Banker and the history of it. I know you got to go, so I'm going to let you go.
You,
I know
Angela.
She's got a lot going on today. Thank you for taking the time.
You're welcome,
I do appreciate it. And maybe we'll do another Q&A later so where we can break it down into a little more detail and get a little bit in depth about Coldwell Banker.
That sounds great.
Yeah. All right, girl.
So today I want to talk a little bit about the history of Coldwell Banker. Most of you may not know the history of Coldwell Banker. And for me, history is very important. It shows the building blocks and the foundation of a company and how they have expanded and grown throughout the years. So I wanted to start in the beginning. In 1906 in San Francisco, there was an earthquake. And shortly after this earthquake, trying to get the San Francisco built back up, a guy by the name of Colbert Coldwell founded a real estate company in San Francisco, California, and based on the principles of honesty, integrity, and service. In 1913, Mr. Coldwell brings on a sales agent. His name is Benjamin Arthur Banker. And after a year of being a sales agent, he decided to partner with him. They ended up changing the name to Coldwell, Cornwallis, and Banker. The company just continued to grow, and many, many offices were opened throughout California. In 1940, Mr. Cornwell resigns and the company once again changes its name, this time to Coldwell Banker and Company. 1952, just 12 years later, the Coldwell Banker brand opens its first office outside of California. They open it up in a little shopping center in Phoenix, Arizona. In 1965, unfortunately, Benjamin Arthur Banker dies at the age of 80 in Oakland, California. And just 2 years after that, the founder of Coldwell Banker, Mr. Colbert Coldwell, dies at the age of 84. Mind you that he never retired from working from Coldwell Banker. In 1968, after 50 years as a partnership and 5 years as a privately held corporation, Coldwell Banker became a publicly traded company in November, again, in 1968. Fast forward to today, Coldwell Banker has been in the business for over 114 years. It's still the number one top producing company in the world. Just in the U.S. alone, Coldwell Banker NRT has more than 50 affiliate sales associates. It has 5,200 employees and approximately 800 offices all ready to serve you. If you want an opportunity to talk with someone about working at Coldwell Banker, if you're a new agent, want to just interview and see what's going on, you guys can reach out to my broker, Carrie Collins. She'd be more than happy to set an appointment with you. Or if you just want to know a little bit more about Coldwell Banker and how it works, I would be more than happy to help you. Give me a call, 803-727-4176.